कैन यू सी माई स्क्रीन?
या मैम,
ओके Okay, so to start up with TQM, we know what is meant by TQM already. It's total quality management. Just one second.
हेलो
हेलो,
मैम, गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून गौतम। ओके, सो वी विल स्टार्ट विथ टोटल क्वालिटी मैनेजमेंट। सो वी नो व्हाट इज मीन बाय टोटल क्वालिटी मैनेजमेंट। सो टोटल इज द कंप्लीट थिंग एंड क्वालिटी इज अबाउट डिग्री ऑफ एक्सलेंस इन द प्रोडक्ट और सर्विसेज और व्हाट एवर वर्क वी आर बीइंग एग्जीक्यूटिंग। एंड मैनेजमेंट इज समथिंग विच इज एक्ट और मैनर ऑफ handling, controlling. So this is total quality management. That is TQM is the art of managing the whole to achieving excellence. So we saw quality management system, which is QMS. We also saw quality control techniques, which is QC. We also studied about quality assurance, which is QA. So compiling all these three together, put up into one word, is said to be TQM. That is total quality management. So when we hear from the company saying we are executing a total quality management, it means they have a separate quality team in the company to carry on all their audit systems or quality control systems. So TQM is a management approach for an organization centered on quality based on the participation of all its members and aiming at long-term success through customer satisfaction and benefits to all members of the organization and to society. This will be your definition of TQM. So just memorize this definition, and when they ask in the 4-mark question, you need to explain this TQM definition and what is mean by total and what is mean by quality and what is mean by management, and all together put up as a TQM. So total is organization wide, quality is you have to explain the quality definition. And management is again system of managing. So see, this is put up together, a management strategy aimed at embedding awareness of quality in all organizational process. So see, this is how the evolution of quality era happened. So starting from 1900 till date, how the quality era has been improvised. So first, starting with the quality system was in aspects of only in the see, this is the another flow chart and this is one more flow chart. So if you see in the earlier years, it was in the quality only in the work life. See here, it was with the craftsmen, foremen, then the inspection happened, then came the SQC. What is mean by SQC? SQC is nothing but statistical quality control. Then that SQC got transformed to TQC, that is total quality control, then TQC, then after that it was emerged to the TQM, that is total quality management. So these are the steps how a total quality management system is being evolved in the organization. See, first the quality of work life, quality circle, then they concentrated in the productivity and employee involvement, then employees empowerment, Then they also brought up assurance and training systems to quality. That is where the even the employees in the organizations got trained on quality circles, and through them the total quality will be implemented in the organization. So finally they will evolve into TQC or TQM. So it is a self-directed management managed teams. So when we have a TQM team in the company, it means we can take care of our own quality systems implemented in the company. See, this is the thing. So we have to concentrate on customer satisfaction and we have to fulfill the expectations of the customer. There is one more model of TQM, which is umbrella model of TQM. These are the general terms of the TQM. SPC, JIT, TEI, Kaizen is all. It's all the general technical terms of the TQM. What are the factors they will implement and they will take care is the quality assurance, customer satisfaction, problem solving tools and the Taguchi methods. Taguchi methods is nothing but we will see many quality gurus in coming slides. So that is one of the methods which has been proposed by one of the quality guru. So what are the approaches to achieve the total quality management? A committed and involved management to provide long-term top-to-bottom organizational support. Then an unwavering focus on the customer, both internally and externally. Effective involvement and utilization of the entire workforce. So what all does this mean? How TQM will be approached and achieved in an organization? Yes, we are running a proper full-fledged TQM in an organization. When can you say that all these approaches has to be satisfied? You need to have a committed and involved management to provide. First, your management team should be properly committed and involved. Only then they will be able to provide proper information to all the organizational members. So that is the first point. And your customer satisfaction, you should understand what is the focus of the customer, both internally and externally. That is the second thing. And again, the involvement of the workforce, that is involvement of the different people in the organization. Then continuous improvement of the business and production process, treating supplier as partners, establish performance measures for the process. These are all the important points. There has to be a continuous improvement in your business process. As we saw the graphical approach in the previous slides, so there shouldn't be any falling down. There has to be a continuous improvement of the business. Then your suppliers has to be treated as partners. Then your performance measures has to be established for the processor. So what are the new and old cultures? See, quality element TQM. Definition is the product, customer, priority, service and cost, quality. We also saw about quality, cost, that is what they are talking. And making decisions, short-term decisions and long-term decisions. That is the differentiation. And emphasis is reduction and prevention. As we saw about preventive measure and corrective measure, those are the things. Then we have to detect what are the errors, what are the problem solving methods, procurement, what is the manager role, what is the quality manager role, to plan, assign, enforce, delegate, coach and mentor. He has to plan a methodology how the system has to be executed and what work to be assigned to which person. And he has to enforce if the work is really getting done. Then he has to delegate the work to different persons in the organization. If necessary, he also has to coach the person, that is the quality training has to be given. Then he also needs to act as a quality mentor. So these are the companies where TQM has been implemented successfully. Some of the name well-known company, that is TVS Group, Boeing Aircraft, Reliance, Tata, L&T and ITI. So these are the gurus of TQM who I was talking about. So you will not get in a very detailed question on gurus of TQM. but you may get any FOMA question just to ask or explain the gurus of TQM or who are the gurus of TQM or explain the definition given by the specific guru of TQM. So see, we will just read out the names. So first one is the Walter, second one is Edwards Deming. And he is the one, Edwards Deming is the one who gave 14 points in PDCA cycle. Last class, we were seeing what is mean by PDCA cycle, that is Plan, Do, Check, Act. So, Deming is the person who formulated that PDCA circle. Then, Joseph M. Juran, he gave Triology. And next one is the Feigenbaum. He was talking about the customer requirement and what is the total quality control. So next one is the Ishikawa. He was saying about the disciple of Juran and TQC in Japan. Next is the Phillips B. Crosby. So Crosby is the one who gave the absolute definition of the quality management. So whenever we ask, there will be a question, defined quality management as per Crosby. So what was the quality management stated by Crosby? So you have to write the definition. Taguchi. See, this is Taguchi, is one of the quality guru who was giving methodology to be followed in the umbrella model of the TQM. Okay, this is again some of the definitions of that quality gurus. So the first, the in the top shown is the ISO 9000, that is the definition. Quality is the degree to which a set of inherent characteristics fulfills requirements. So quality, how it can be quantified, that is how it can be measured. P by E, what is P? Performance, and E is the expectation. So performance divided by expectation is the way to measure your quality. So what is being performed and what was expected? If you divide that and if you get the if your ratio has worked out properly, then the quality has been achieved in your project. So Crosby, he has stated quality is conformance to requirements. Edwards Deming, a predictable degree of uniformity and dependability at low cost and suited to market. So this is again one of the definition by Deming. So what are the different dimensions of quality? One is durability, the next one is service, the third is response, fourth is the aesthetics, and the fifth is the reputation. So durability, what is the durability? Let it be a material or let it be a service, let it be a product. So whichever we are talking about, durability is the most important and first factor where the quality management system is dependent on. Next is the service, resolution of problems, ease of repair. So service is something when a product or material is being installed at the site, you need to look up for the service if maintenance part is easy. So that is next dimension of the quality. Response, human relations with customer, how the human how the HR team or how the marketing team, how they are being responded to the customer questions, that is customer satisfaction, how your organization is being worked for the customer satisfaction. And fourth is the aesthetics, that is sensory features. So what are the different aesthetic features that also can be implemented as a part of quality? Then reputation. Reputation is nothing but your performance measures, evaluation of your performance. So quality cost, so different costs of the quality. So that is prevention cost, planning, document, control, training, appraisal cost, inspection, text, installation, calibre. So okay, prevention cost is something, planning, document, control, all these will be in the paperwork. Appraisal cost is something, what inspections, what test, or what any report or any installation, any commissioning has to be conducted, that is the appraisal cost. Internal failure cost, what is the internal failure cost? If a plan is being designed by an architect, okay, it is being getting given to the client. It is going for the client's approval, and then it will go for the local authority body approval. If somewhere it is getting rejected, or if it somewhere is being put up for some question, then if everything has to be revised and you have to rework, then that some cost incurs due to that. That kind of cost is called as internal failure cost. What is external failure cost? A project is being completed and it is being in functioning. Okay, that time when there is some complaint from the occupants or some services is going, there is no durability of the services being installed, or if some material is going waste or it is not being working, then so those costs, whatever cost is being incurred by those errors, then that cost is called as external failure cost. This is a general graphical representation of the quality of conformance. So see, the red one is the prevention and appraisal cost, and this yellow one is the internal and external failure cost. Summing up together is the total cost. And if you take a average of both prevention and appraisal cost and internal and external failure cost, the average of both will be your optimum total cost spent for executing the total quality management system in your organization. Okay, so now coming to what will be the obstacles for the total quality management system to be implemented in an organization. First is the top management committee. Next is changing organization culture. Third is the improper planning. And fourth is continuous training and education. First, top management committee. There will be many miscommunications, or there will be a problem in the hierarchy system. So many other so-and-so problems will be arising. That will be one of the obstacle. Next is changing organization culture. A team will be put up for working on the certain products or certain materials. But suddenly when that team is being shifted to work on the other material, and the another team is being replaced to work on this material, so certain changing the hierarchy or changing the organizational structure, this will be one of the obstacle. And third is the improper planning. And fourth is your giving continuous training and education. That is again a problem in an organization. We always look up for getting our end product very easily and very soon, where we will lag this continuous training. So we also need to plan up. A training session has to always happen in an organization, and parallelly a productivity session also needs to happen. Organization structure, the first thing which I was talking, data and facts for effective decisions, internal and external customer dissatisfaction. So customer satisfaction, which we were talking about, same thing, empowerment and teamwork. Again, a teamwork, which is a problem everywhere in every organization in the whole world. That is also again one of the biggest obstacle in the TQM. And continuous improvement. We need to always look up for if there is a continuous improvement in the organization structure. So what will be the benefits if you are executing the TQM? So there will be improved quality, employee participation, teamwork, internal and external customer satisfaction, productivity and communication, profitability and market share. So these are the benefits of the TQM. So this is about TQM. So you may get a question on TQM. What are the benefits of TQM, or what are the components of TQM? Explain the TQM in graphical representation. You will get in the part B question also and part A question also. I'll send you extra notes also along with this. So it will be easy for you to handle. Now let's go to quality audit. I'll just go to it. What is the reason and why we are conducting quality audits? So, quality audit, I'll just project. Just one second. Okay, I think you can see my screen. Are you able to see my screen?
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. So last class we saw what are the different types of the audit. So we know internal audit and external audit, and we also familiar with the first party audit and second and third party audit. So now we will look into what is the purpose and why we need to do this audit, and who are the persons behind the audit, and what is the reason behind these audits. So see, this is the general classification of the audit: external, internal. So surveys, second party and third party, that is on external side. Internal is with first party and documentation. So this is familiar. So internal and first party. So that is an organization auditing which happens within the company. A person inside the company itself will be an auditor. He'll be sitting in the office, who will document the work has been done, and he will submit the report of that audit, and a follow-up session will be happening for that audit. External is something where we will hire audit. Who are the persons who are in charge of authorizing, yes, this company is being implementing the quality management system, and this can be a ISO certified company. So these external or second party auditors are the members who will evaluate our company on terms of ISO or quality management systems. So who are those third party? Independent of the organization being audited, used to certify, register or verify. So the below mentioned FDA, AATB, these are the different third party auditor organizations who are the persons comes for auditing. So audit types, internal. So what will be the requirement of internal audits? So quality assurance program. So the director shall require a documented annual internal review or audit to ensure compliance with the regulation and standard. So first the company or company director or the manager who takes care of the project, he has to ensure if all the documents submitted is complies with the regulations and the norms. Then a periodical performance has to be taken care of it. Then internal audit, what is the reason to perform? What is the reason for self evaluation? Value added to management, what value will it achieve for the company? First point. Then conformance to internal procedure, often a visual of a task or a review of documentation. Then third is compliance to regulation. Fourth is effectiveness of the corrective actions. And fifth is good business practice, and they make sense. So these are the reasons why an internal audit has to be done before we are going in for the external audit. So who can perform the internal audit? A trained staff not directly responsible for what is being audited, outside consultant if no one is available. So possibly a trained staff, but he should not be directly involved in your project. That person should not be working in your project, but he can be a member of the company. So what type of records will an internal auditor review? All your policies and procedures. So far you should have, when a quality is being implemented in a project, definitely there will be project quality plan, that is quality policies. Next, the records, what all records has been maintained for the specific project. Then observation of the process within the scope of the audit. Then your training records. Definitely there has to be a quality training happening in your project or process. So you need to have record of those training. There will be a certain set of training, this many number of training has needs to happen in the project or process. So that many number of training records has to be maintained, which will be reviewed by the internal auditor. So what type of records he will not review? So personal records, that is the human who are the people who been worked in the project, how many, not that kind thing. Health records will not be reviewed, disciplinary records will not be reviewed, human resource records specific to employees, and accounting records. So these are the records where it will not be evaluated in internal audit. So role of the internal auditor, he'll be like a catalyst, an interface between groups, advisor, and reporter of the facts. So internal auditor basically can become a internal consultant for the organization. In many organization, either the person sitting inside the company itself will be the auditor. If you go for big scale company, there will be a different department called as auditing department. So that case of the company will run their internal audit through that department, and they will get the internal audit report. There will be a small company where you will not have any internal auditor sitting inside the company, but it is compulsory. You need to have a second party or third party audit at the year end, or maybe in the couple of the years. So when they come for the review, they will definitely ask for the internal audit report, and they'll also ask for how many months duration you have had your internal audit. So in that case, it's necessary and it's very mandatory for even the small organization to have an internal audit. So that in that case, many small organization will hire the auditor from outside, and they will act like an internal auditor for the specific organization. So he will be one of the internal consultant for the organization. So next, coming to the second party audit. So one organization auditing another, with which it either has or is going to have a contract or agreement for the supply of goods or services. So I think it's clear. So comprehensive evaluation performed by customer to help ensure that supplier is operating under a state of control. Periodic auditing or AATB requires biennially. So second party auditing is something where either two companies can have a mutual understanding, two or three companies. Auditor from a company can be shifted to the others, and they can do the regular audit, and audit report can be submitted. That is the second party. So again, what is the requirement for a second party audit? Audit prior to executing a contract and thereafter must be documented. Follow-up verification can be paper audit or on-site audit. So prior to the audit, a contract has to be executed, then the audit has to be documented, then a follow-up audit has to be conducted, either at site or at paper level. So what are the reasons to perform? It help ensure the proper capability, quality system, promotes understanding of expectation of the customer, then provides for an avenue of quality transfer between the supplier and customer, builds customer confidence. So these are the reason for performing second party audit. So who can perform an external audit? Staff trained in conducting external audit. Internal audit and external audit quite differ in approaches and techniques, and outside consultant. So these are the people who can perform the external audit. What an external auditor will review? So he will review your quality manual or plan, that is the PQP, project quality plan. Then what is the organizational chart? What do you mean with this organizational chart? This is the hierarchy chart of the organization. So next is the registration license, that is if the company is the licensed and if the project has the proper approval from the local body authorities. So that is one of the thing. Next, your policies and procedure, and what is the records, and what is the observation of the process, and what is the training records. So these are the documents which an external auditor will review. So what he will not review, the same thing what we saw for internal auditor, only one thing is added is the internal audit reports. Now coming to third party audit. So what a third party auditor will review? A quality manual, again an organizational chart, and he can also review the schedules and procedures for management review on for internal and external audits. So third party auditor is the person who will review the previous audits happened, if internal audit has happened really in the company, how many times it has happened, and if any second party audit is also conducted. Normally in all organization, not three level audits will be happening. Only in your corporate company or multi-level company will have this three level of auditing. Or else in normal, in our country or in our in Chennai, if you take, in many builders association or in with many promoter, there will be one auditing happening at the year end. That is the external audit. That is one external audit who will be giving the ISO certification. Yes, these are the points to improve and these are the points to be appreciated, and this is the value. This is the value they get out of this much. So that audit will happen, and within a year they will have audit quarterly, that is every quarterly. That every quarterly audit is called as internal audit, and the year end happening audit is called as the external audit. So subtype, what are the approach, what are the subtypes of the audit, scope of the audit, and why the audit is being performed. So subtype, recovery process, processing processes, distribution process, quality process. So these are the subtypes. So so if the audit is not happening, what will be the risk factors? So following is the four risk factor. One is the health risk, process risk, business risk, and the compliance risk. So with this we will finish this thing. Okay, so we'll finish the class with this.
Okay, mom.
Chiri, I'll send you the question bank. Your most of the questions will be from unit 1, unit 2, and unit 4. Now what we saw, the different types of the audit, and what is TQM, and what the previous class, what we saw, quality management systems, and what are the quality control techniques. So these will be the more familiar questions which will you will be getting for your exams. But still, I'll send you your question bank. You can refer to it. Sorry. Anything else?